You're watching the free version of Mocha Essentials. Follow along with projects and footage with a premium download available at borisfx.com.
And we're back. So let's troubleshoot this shot. We are going to troubleshoot this shot using basically all of the settings inside of the remove module. So you can see there's a couple of problems here. One of the problems is, as this guy walks by towards the end, you can see just a little bit of pixels because we just had a little bit of jitter and didn't have any pixels to replace those pixels with. We might get away with using flood fill to try to fix that. And that's where flood fill can actually help us. So now if you look, if we re-render this whole shot, those original pixels we couldn't replace, we just replaced with more color of the road. There are very few shots where you'll tend to get away with that, but for little tiny edges, yeah, you can probably get away with it, especially on skies, roads, grasslands, etc. Now, I do have one more thing that I see as kind of a problem. As we move through the shot, we have a little bit of stepping, and that's because the actual lighting is changing because he's moving through a street light and his shadow is actually being projected onto that building. Well, we want to see if we can get rid of some of that. So we're going to go ahead and use blend, and we're going to crank up this blend amount just as high as it'll go and hit render forwards. And that gives us poor results. So I don't want to use blend. But here's how I can fix that. I can go into my clean plate clip and hit create clean plate and save this in my work folder. I can go to the end of my shot and create another clean plate. I'll use clean plates exclusively and hit render forwards. And now we don't see as much of a ripple as he moves by. To further troubleshoot this, I can add some feathering. We'll add a whole lot of feathering. Turn our overlays off and hit render forwards again. And I can always add more clean plates. At this point, I almost don't see where he's crossing. But there's other stuff that we can do to troubleshoot this. So we could try a linear illumination modeling, which would try to raise and lower all of the pixels inside of his shape based on the hue and saturation and value all around the shape that I created for the remove and see what that gets me. And that gets me something that looks pretty good. But if I really wanted to really dive in and match every single pixel edge as we walked by, we could also use interpolate and see what that looks like. The problem with using interpolate is that sometimes you can get a little bit of a flicker. So usually linear is going to be the choice that you want to use. Now that looks pretty good to me. I can still see just a very, very little bit of ghosting. And I can try to fix that by either not using clean plates exclusively and seeing what that gets me. And I would call that remove 99% done. We could also troubleshoot this by going to my remove guy layer, turning my layers back on. Using link to track, none, because now that we've created our clean plates, we can just use our clean plates. And then just creating a nice big shape. And replacing everything in this shape. Using our clean plates exclusively. And this is totally a cheat. But now we have no ghosting at all. And we're still matching the lighting changes from the exposure changes of the camera. So that's a really basic remove and how to troubleshoot a remove. Back in your plugin, you can select your remove and click render. And you can render this right back to your timeline inside of After Effects. I'd still probably add a degrain and match grain to make this fit everything, but that looks pretty good to me. So let's talk about when you absolutely have to use clean plates, though. Join me on our next lesson, The removed module part 2A.
You've been watching the free version of Mocha Essentials. To download all videos, projects, and footage, purchase the premium version available at borisfx.com.